Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you back on another episode on Air Power Employment. Today, the domain which we're going to look at is SEAD or DEAD as it is known in the military circles. Specific suppression of enemy air defense or destruction of enemy air defense is pivotal in air power to have its complete freedom to operate. If I were to look at history, it is a clear indication that SEAD and DEAD operations have been used from the times of World War II into the Korean War era into the Vietnam War. Maybe the Rolling Thunder operation, Linebacker 1, Linebacker 2. Both ways, it has remained important to achieve military and political objectives in an air power arena. As we know, air power is an instrument of policy. Policy given by the grand strategic level of an organization or a country, as we call it. Starting from the Shrike AGM-45 or the AGM-78, once again, Linebacker 2 and 1 both have had this success story going for them. Let's jump ahead a few years. We look at the Gulf War 1, where SEAD and DEAD, both type of operations, were utilized to its most efficient effect. And if we are very cognizant of timelines, at the very onset of operations, Gulf War I against Saddam Hussein, the allied nations utilized the standard low high profiles with tornadoes. First night, there were a few, if not many, tornadoes that were lost during those timelines. But better sense prevailed. SEAD, DEAD operations were brought in with the help of F-117 stealth aircraft, the Nighthawk as they call it, and it was very successful from that point onwards. Once again, the air defense system, being mostly Russian at that time with Iraq, was decently integrated and it was very successful. What is of learning value to us in contemporary times? Now we are jumping ahead 30 odd years to the times of 2020 plus, where S-400 has become the name of integrated networked air defense systems worldwide, starting from Turkey to India to a few other countries. But let's make it specific to the subcontinent. The S-400 is a very, very potent and specific layered defense system built on a few ESA radars and its technology that comes across, where they are different TR modules which independently operate as radars themselves. The codename Triumph has a few integrated radar systems once again. The most famous of it is 91N6E or 91 November 6 Echo panoramic radar. It has got the capability of anti-stealth. It has the capability to take care of cruise missiles as well. If I be specific on distances and ranges, anti-stealth or low observable, 150 kilometers. Ballistic targets, 0.4 meters square to 30 kilometers. RCS of fighter aircraft, 4 meters square plus minus 390 kilometers. Strat bombers, 570, because of greater RCS or radar cross section, it can be picked up at greater ranges. So it is extremely capable. The Indians have it. They will be utilizing it in the future domains or future wars or conflicts or battles. May it be with the Western friends, us, Pakistan, or as claimed by the CDS, of Chief of Defense Staff in India, Bipin that we are ready for a two-prong war with Pakistan and China both. So it will be an important element of the air power utility, because once again, present times, air power determines wins and losses both sides. You can have seen it in the previous Nagorno-Karabakh region as well. UAVs and UCAF technology played its role. So air power is pivotal. What I would also like to say here, yes, it is important, but what is more critical is to how to counter this menace, as we call it. And very candidly, there are ways and means to take care of this fact. The methodology to the madness. One, using a longer range anti-radiation missile, ARM as they call it. It is no secret that Pakistan has its ballistic missile program, which has been going on for some time now. The epitome of it is the Ababil MIRV specific multiple independent targetable re-entry vehicle ballistic missile program, or the missile itself. It is very competent and it can take care of S-400 without too much of a hassle because of its greater ranges. But what is also important, we have this ALCM, which is also known as Hatef 8, RAD as it is known within the aviation circles. It is an air launch cruise missile, which is once again open information utilized by the Mirages to take out longer ranges. Once again, 300 with the earlier version, and the latest updates or upgrades have forced it to a 600 kilometer radius of action as well. So that being there, so S-400 within the ranges, as we know, 390 kilometers for 4 meter square RCS aircraft, a fighter aircraft, it outsticks it as the numbers go. So that is there. We have once again capability with standoff weapons as well, which can negate the advantage of the enemy, which is on our eastern front. So considering the SEAD-DEAD operation, it is extremely complex, yes, but not impossible. Challenging to domains of utilizing electronic warfare, ECM, ECCM features, as well as utilizing maximum capability of the guy sitting in the cockpit. I would like to reiterate my phrase, which I've done before: the gun matters, but the man behind the gun matters more. So the pilot capability skill set, which has been demonstrated on 27th February 2019, of using standoff capability, may it be the Mirages or the JF-17s, will hold valid. One should never underestimate the enemy. That is key to survival and key to success as well. I would also like to say here that the Air Force is cognizant of the requirement of the times. We continue to evolve ourselves. Another anti-radiation missile that I would like to speak on is the MAR-1. It was acquired from Brazil some years back, utilized on both the Mirage as well as the JF-17 platform. So it is used exactly for the same purpose, which is SEAD and DEAD, suppression of enemy air defense or destruction of enemy air defense.